What's up? This is Patrick.
And I'm Adam.
And in this video, we're going to show you how to give people access to your lake database. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both
Adam
and this guy. All right, Adam, it's been a long time since we've done a video together, and I'm really excited about it. I keep trying to get you to come and do a video with me, but you don't want to because you want people to actually watch your videos.
No. I'm doing the video with you because I want people to watch your video.
So, as of late, Adam and I have been swimming in the lake. We've been talking about lake houses and lake databases. A little backstroke. We've been building these lake databases, and I wanted to give access, Adam, to one that I built so we can kind of take a look at the data for some things we're working on. So I sent him a link, but we ran into a problem.
Patrick thinks the problem is me.
I never cause problems.
All right.
Enough of all this talking. You know how we like to do. Let's head over to your machine.
Let's head over to my machine. Show me. All right. I've got Management Studio here, and I just copied and pasted the server name that you gave me, and I'm going to connect. And I get login fail for user.
It don't work.
You know what would make this work if we enable Kerberos?
Kerberos cannot fix this. There's going to be a lot of people taking that adventure into lake databases and lake houses and things like that. And we want to make sure we give people enough permissions so they can read from these databases. So I think I know how to quickly fix this. This is just a login problem. I need to create a user for you in this database.
So all right.
Enough of all this talking. Let's head over to my laptop. So I'm going to use my trusty friend SQL Server Management Studio. Now, I've already authenticated and connected to this. Okay. Now, let me step back 1 second because I need to point something out. What we are connecting to in Synapse is your serverless endpoint because this is a lake database. All right. Not a dedicated SQL endpoint, your serverless endpoint. So because I'm in the administrator here, I'm able to authenticate and see all the things. But I need to create a user in this database to give Adam access to. And what we're gonna do is there's a link that describes all this stuff. And guess what we're gonna put it in the description below.
In the description.
We're gonna put it in the description. So once you get connected as the administrator, make sure you're in the context of that database that you wanna give that person access to. And so what I'm doing here is I'm gonna say create user from an external provider because I'm using Adam's email address. And so I'm gonna go ahead and create that user. And then I'm gonna add Adam to DB data reader because I want him to see all the tables and I want him to read all the tables in the database. So I'm going to go ahead and run that script. And now, Adam, if we head back to your laptop, you should be able to connect. It's just that easy.
All right, here we go. Moment of truth. Let's connect.
That's okay. Do this for me, Adam. Do this. Go to options and change that to Lake House in an hour. That's the name of the database.
That worked.
That's the only database you have access to. And I didn't set your default database. So this should work, right?
Now I need my data.
Yeah. Expand that database.
I'm going to go to expand tables. External tables. So let's see if I can see fax sales. I'm just going to do select top 1,000 rows. Ready for my data.
That's a good error for me. As a person that's very familiar with how you build these lake houses, there's some storage that contains all the files that I'm querying. Because I'm literally querying these Parquet files. These are Delta files that I'm querying, and I need to give you access to these. Let's go back to my laptop. Let me show you how you do this. Is you head over to the data lake that your Synapse server is using, and we're going to grant you some access here, Adam. So I'm going to go here, and then what you want to do, search for contributor, and there's going to be one down here called Storage Blob Data Contributor. That's the one you want to give them access to. Awesome. Click next. Let's say select member. Here, there's Adam's alias. Select them. Boom. And next, and review and assign. There we go. So it's assigning you. I'm just getting you all set up. So now.
So now we want to try it again. Let's go back to my machine.
Yeah.
Here we go. Execute.
Well, I want you to do me a favor. Disconnect and reconnect.
Here, I'm gonna close Management Studio. Let's go back in. Let's reconnect. Here we go. Database. Lake House in an hour. Tables. External tables. Nope, not system. Fax sales. Select top.
Oh,
it worked. Okay. It worked. It's going to take a little bit to propagate.
You got to be patient.
Patrick's not a patient person.
I'm not a patient person.
All right, so I got my data.
You take those 2 steps, though, Adam.
Ooh, is it perhaps a Texas 2-step?
But you need to make sure that you create that user, give that user access within the context of that database, and then go make sure that they're a storage blob contributor. Once you do that, be a little patient, and you have access to the lake database.
The lake database.
This is serverless. This is serverless in action.
We're swimming in the lake. All right, so we want to hand it over to you. Do you have questions? Does this make sense in terms of how you can get people access to the lake through Synapse? Let us know where down in the comments below. If you like this video, be sure to give us a big thumbs up. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both
Patrick
and this guy, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome. And we'll see you in the next video.
To stay up to date from all the videos.
Do it again. I hit the mic. I'm sorry. That was my bad.